He convicted for rape is now a free man. After serving 25 years in jail, he's now suing the city after charges were dismissed.
Fox 59's Kelly Rinke joins us now from the newsroom tonight with the latest on the allegations brought up in this lawsuit.
Yeah, well, there are six officers named in this lawsuit. The complaint is also against the city of Muncie and employees of the state police crime lab that claims a man was unjustly imprisoned before he was released through DNA evidence. Walking free for the first time in 25 years. This is William Barnhouse in 2017 after prosecutors dismissed charges filed against him in 1992.
He certainly can't get those 25 years back of his life, but we hope that we can achieve to shed a light on what happened.
Heather Lewis Donnell is one of the Chicago attorneys representing him in this federal lawsuit. Barnhouse was convicted of rape and sentenced to 80 years in prison.
We filed this lawsuit to seek justice and compensation.
His conviction centered around a crime near a village pantry in Muncie, where a man threatened a woman with a knife and raped her. Barnhouse's attorneys believe an employee of the Indiana State Police Crime Lab falsely claimed hair found on the victim was so sufficiently similar to Mr. Barnhouse's pubic hair sample that it must be a match.
That kind of injustice is the kind of cases we seek to redress.
The lawsuit says Barnhouse was born with a chromosomal condition that makes him unable to produce sperm. In 2016, a Delaware County court granted a request for DNA testing on the victim's genes and rape kit. A year later, the Delaware County Prosecutor's Office dismissed the charges after the analysis found the sperm on the victim's genes did not belong to Barnhouse.
If you didn't have enough, you couldn't do it back in the old days. And now it can be replicated with science.
Doug Coons is a former FBI agent, and he says since the 1990s, advances in DNA testing have greatly expanded, making it more likely for investigators to get a positive identification.
It takes a much shorter time to get results back. You can have degraded samples are not necessarily bad.
The lawsuit says Barnhouse never gave up on his innocence, and now his attorneys want to take the city to court.
For him, his name to be cleared and to understand what happened to him was wrong.
Now, the Delaware County's prosecutor told me the case was not dismissed because the state felt he was innocent or wrongfully convicted, but rather they believe the case could not be proven beyond a reasonable doubt. Dan, back to you.
Okay, Kelly, thank you. Well, the first day of